get ready to discover a whole new side of our beloved industry icons. I'm Bianca Gonzalez, and welcome to The B-Side. From matinee idol to award-winning actor, he conquered the hearts of fans and film critics alike, and since then, he has taken his talents to the culinary and business world. Expanding to many, many restaurants under his name, he has proven himself to be one of the country's top restaurateurs.
Mama, thank you, my love. Sa lahat-lahat, tulong mo sa pag-intindi mo sa akin.
Hindi ko naman sinasadyang lokohin ka eh. Sorry na talaga, babe.
Huwag mo ako tinatawag na babe!
Diretsuhin mo nga ako. Dahil hindi ko kayang basahin kung anong nandyan sa utak mo. Kung galit ka, sabihin mo sa akin kung bakit. Kung nasaktan kita, sampalin mo ako. Sige, gantihan mo ako. Matatanggap ko lahat dahil kaibigan mo ako eh.
Oh yes, kaibigan mo ako! And that's all I ever was to you, Ned. Juan! Bakit hindi mo sinabi sa mama?
Iya ko. Pahalay ako, diba?
Uwi na tayo. Uwi na tayo.
Welcome to the B-Side, Mr. Marvin Agustin!
Hello, B!
Ang saya ko makabisita dito in one of Marvin's many restaurants. This is Kochi in the heart of BGC. Congratulations!
Mag-one year
na!
Yes.
I love that. Siyempre, pag-uusapan natin ang naging journey ni Marvin as a restaurateur. And later, we're gonna check out the kitchen as well.
Mm-hmm.
When did you realize that you wanted to have your own restaurant?
Bago yung my own restaurant, when I was working in the restaurant, mm-hmm. when I was 15 as a waiter, mascot, when I was 13, 14, my dream then was to be the manager of the restaurant.
Wait, manager because?
Kasi nga parang natutuwa ako na parang siya yung nag-orchestrate ng buong operations namin, which is actually very hard to mm-hmm. do because mm-hmm. a lot of staff are front of the house and then back of the house. Tapos, kita ko lang parang galing-galing niya. So, parang dream ko of becoming a manager. Kaya, during the time, the company would actually send me to school in the morning and then magtatrabaho ka sa kanila at night. Sayang, okay. Di natuloy yun. Kasi nga, nag-artista na ako.
Yes.
Tapos, nung na-realize ko kasi nakakaipon na ako, doon ako nagkaroon ng dream. Sabi ko, siguro pwede ako magkaroon ng restaurant ko. Doon nagsimula yung dream. Na-inlove ako doon sa service. You're making a family happy. You're serving yeah. them. From the time that they come in mm-hmm. the restaurant, masigasuhin mo sila. Ang immediate kasi nung response, kung okay at pangit ng ginawa mo, mm-hmm. kaya you're striving na maganda kasi papasalamatan ka nila
yes.
at mapaparamdam nila sa'yo that they had a great time versus sa pag mali yung service, mm-hmm. nakunagot ka. Aawayin ka ng customer.
Aww.
So I realized and I experienced that early on in life.
Mm-hmm. And imagine, next year, 2025, you will have been 20 years a restaurateur.
Well,
2005, si Sumo Sam?
Yes, 2005.
First ever?
20 years. Kasi yung kids ko, mm-hmm. yan yung pag-number
marker.
Ko eh. Kasi nung pinanganak sila, doon din yung time na binubuksan namin si Sumo Sam.
Oh my gosh, sabay.
Yeah. Yeah.
Grabe yung pagkasabay ng mga life milestones.
Yes.
Does it feel like 20 years of running businesses?
Sa challenges, yes. Nakakapagod siya. Pero nakaka-expand ng pagkatao.
Yes.
Ang daming matututunan.
Yes.
Sabi nga nila, yung negosyo is a reflection of the entrepreneur. So, sa dami ng pinagdaanan ko, sa dami na din ng milestones ng mga restaurants that
yes.
I've handled, parang looking back, mahirap man, pero you felt like you grew with the
right.
brand, you learned so much with the brand, you met a lot of interesting people
mm-hmm.
along the way. So,
yeah.
Sarap.
Pero bago ka sumugal with your own restaurant in 2005, franchise mo
yes.
pala. Bakit yun ang ruta at hindi? Negosyo ko agad.
Because from being an employee in the restaurant concept, mm-hmm. nag-artista ako. And Mr. Donut got me as an endorser. Mm-hmm. So sabi ko, huwag niyo akong bayaran ng talent fee. Just give me a franchise. Oh. Para matutunan ko yung negosyo because that's kind of for me parang a good way to start and introduce yourself in a food business yeah. that you would own dahil may guidance ka from the principal, meron kang ready products na ibebenta yeah. na yung learning curve mas madali. Kaya nung natuto na, parang mas may confidence na okay. creating your own concept and then running
yeah. it. You had that foresight, hindi siya yung TF ang gusto ko, kundi parang teach a man to fish and you will help him feed himself for the rest of his lifetime.
I guess the experience of being an employee, and I fell in love in yeah. the restaurant business and working with different kinds of people. It's something that nung nakaipon na sa ko, I wanna go back to that industry. Dami kong natutunan kasi dito. So yeah. I'm just, I guess, continuing the experience. Waiter din ako dati, and ang ini-inspired, motivate namin yan, the waiters, front of the house, even back of the house. Training them, inspiring them to not just do a great work, but mm-hmm. honing their personality and character. Para ka rin nagbi-build up ng mga artista. I'm teaching them how to perform for the customers because they actually hear either, di ba, pangit yung araw nila o sobrang saya sila sa gaya na gusto silang mag-celebrate. So, they're looking for not just great food, but right. a great service from us. So, that's one thing that I would always tell them. Treat them with, you know, the best way you can.
Yeah. Ang galing. So parang meron ding ambag yung pagiging artista mo.
Oh, malaki.
Sa pagiging
malaking ambag. Kasi lagi kong nare-relate sa kanila na itong buong restaurant, stage to ha. So pag nandito tayo, alam ko, may pinagdadaanan tayong lahat. Baka yes. kaka-break mo lang. Mm. Meron ka na pagalitan, may kaaway yes. ka. Pero pagdating dito, performance level tayo. Because we're not paid for our own dramas. So we're paid to give them a great experience.
Yeah. So this first business of yours, this first restaurant, syempre hindi naman siya smooth sailing kaagad. What were the biggest lessons from that first sugal, that first experience?
During that time, putting people together, you know, creating that team, mm-hmm. hindi pala lahat basta-basta magagaling pagsasama-samahin mo and you'd be able to have a great team. Meron ding tamang chemistry para ka rin nagka-casting. Kasi yung personalities, yung characters nagka-clash, isa yun sa mga natutunan ko na kailangan mong hanapin yung tamang participation from mm-hmm. each one of them mm-hmm. and then assemble mo sila and then you have a great team.
So you as a restaurateur, not as Marvin the artista. Mm-hmm. Obviously, in creating dishes, ikaw din yon. In hiring people, ikaw din yon. As in, pati operations, finance, ganyan. Well, did you have to do that in the very start?
Yan nga yung kala nila na ang glamorous ng pagiging negosyante. Yung parang, ha, you have your own time.
As a boss.
Flexible yung araw mo. Hawak mo yung oras mo. Oo, hawak mo kasi yung buong oras mo nagtatrabaho ka. Pag uwi mo, iniisip mo pa rin. Anong nangyayari kaya doon? Anong mangyayari bukas?
Yes.
Being an entrepreneur is a 24/7, 7-day-a-week job. Mm-hmm. From each department, especially finance, yeah. na yun ako siya hindi magaling, but I had to mm-hmm. learn it and I had to be good at it. Mm-hmm. Because at the end of the day, you know, business is about making money. How you do it is another thing. Yan yung bottom line lagi. Kahit sobrang mabait pa kayo, if you're mm-hmm. losing money, then it's not business, di ba? So yeah. that's one thing that you have to always check on.
OMG, have you had to fire people? Marvin started very early. Sabi niya 7 a.m. pa lang, nagte-training na siya
ng mga
staff dito. So pati training is you.
Yes. Because I can inspire them with my story. Mm-hmm. Yung journey ko as a waiter, as a mascot, daladala ko. Pag minotivate ko sila, pag sinabi ko sa kanila na this is the proper way of doing it, mm-hmm. they actually listen more. I train the managers and I train the team. Mm-hmm. So now we're doing a 2-day workshop. FOH, front of the house training. So I'm hands-on with the business.
To those who might not know, front of the house and back of the house means?
So those are the two separations of the of the operations. Mm-hmm. Front of the house is the dining area, and then back of the house is the kitchen. Two very important departments na dapat sobrang cohesive at sobrang connected. Mm-hmm. Because pag hindi sila connected, that's when bad service happens. Yeah. That's when a lot of complaints would happen because disconnected yung dalawang teams. Yeah. So dapat in sync sila, dapat may harmony, mm-hmm. dapat may teamwork.
Yes. You ventured into many, many other cuisines, Kochi being one of the many latest concepts. Mm-hmm. Paano mo malalaman? Paano mo dinidiscarte yun na, okay, dito naman tayo, ganito po siya, try.
Minsan, the Japanese, the reason why we entered the Japanese category during that time was nung sa Shangri-La, there was no Japanese restaurant in the mall. Mm-hmm. If you want to eat the Japanese food, you'd have to go to the hotel, which is, of course, it's pricier.
Yes.
And then there was a fast food on the ground floor, but there's nothing in the middle.
Right.
So there's a crack in the market. So, we conceptualized a Japanese restaurant during that time. So nowadays, ganun pa rin naman. You actually don't create a product, you solve a problem.
Mm,
so if there's a need for it, then somehow you service that need, you service that, you solve that kind of problem, then stronger yung product that you're creating for them.
Did you ever go to any business school or something?
Yes, whenever I would have free time. Since hindi ako nag-college, lagi akong parang merong
gusto
kong bumabalik
talaga
sa eskwelahan. Mm-hmm. So, I'd always take mga short courses. So, nung teenager pa ako yan, nag-arts management ako sa AIM. I took Master Entrepreneurship in Ateneo, but I didn't get to finish it. I still have 2 modules. Mm-hmm. Nag-digital filmmaking ako sa NYU.
Oh, okay.
So kung ano-ano, every time there's free time, pag magbabakasyon ako, nag-aaral ako.
Yeah, which all feed into the many different businesses.
Mm-hmm. Or, of the things that I do.
Right. So far in the almost 20 years, managing and owning your own restaurants, ano yung pinaka, mistake?
Again, manpower and teams and working with people.
Which is not easy talaga.
Yeah, it's not easy. And sometimes kasi you're visualizing something, you have a vision for the company, yung confidence mo at saka yung parang aggressiveness mo dahil parang I went through a lot in life and it's so possible.
Yeah.
Everything is possible.
Yeah.
And parang lahat ng impossible things kaya, pero hindi kaya ng isang tao.
Mm-hmm.
If you're doing something like, a restaurant,
mm-hmm.
you need a competent team.
Right.
You have to grow with the team.
Mm-hmm.
Hindi siya soul of light na tatrabahuhin mo lang, kaya ko to, magaling ako, confident ako. Kailangan mong ma-assemble yung tamang tao.
Yeah. OMG, have you had to fire people?
Come and
ikaw
go. Yeah, lagi siyang come and go. Minsan nga, you take it personally, nalulungkot ka, ganyan.
Oh.
And then after a while, it's just life. Just like life.
Mm-hmm.
They would come and go. Not because they're not good, but because it's not just the right fit.
Right.
They're better off somewhere else. The business has other requirements, not just the skill set of that person. So, hindi dahil sa hindi magaling yung mga tao.
Mm-hmm.
But it's just that the right fit for the circumstance or for that particular time.
Yeah. What kind of a boss/business owner are you?
I'm very strict because it's our customers' happiness and satisfaction. And lagi kong sinasabi sa kanila, they're spending their money, hard-earned money. They're trusting us on that particular time.
Yeah.
Their time and their money. If we won't respect that, why are we in this industry? So, lagi kong sinishare sa kanila. Sabi ko, you guys spend also your hard-earned money to buy food. Do you want to be disrespected? I always paint the scenario. Kung kayo yun, anong gagawin niyo? Mas mabilis yung pagkakaintindihan namin, delivering a great service to our customers.
Yeah.
Doon ako strict.
Mm-hmm.
Kasi I don't like disrespecting time and hard-earned money of people.
You do nga have several restaurants na iba't iba yung cuisine. You also like traveling to try food everywhere.
Yes,
so parang inuwi mo yun, nag-bound ka ng mental notes, or do you have like physical notes lalo when you travel na parang, I want to try this.
Yes.
Ano yung pinaka-inspiring place you've traveled to for food?
My recent favorite city is London.
Daming iba't ibang
ang
cuisine.
Diverse kasi ng London.
Yes.
Ang melting pot ng London.
Mm-hmm.
To be straightforward about it, they really don't have a cuisine.
Correct.
Diba?
Yes.
Nanggaling siya sa influence of a lot of migrants from a lot of different countries and cultures.
Mm-hmm.
And they respect that.
Yeah.
Kaya nag-evolve yung culinary landscape ng London.
Yeah.
Dati nun, what, 15 years ago? Ano ba bang tama yung masarap pagkain doon? Fish and chips? But after a while, because they embraced who they are, hindi nila ikinahiya na wala silang cuisine, but they worked with people and cultures. Mm-hmm. So, sumarap, gumanda, naging truthful, naging sincere, naging mas authentic how they delivered their culinary direction. So, yun. Sarap aralin at that sarap i-experience ng lahat.
And I assume not just dishes yung tinitingnan mo when you travel to restaurants, but pati like the experience, like the way the, they serve, they welcome everything.
The little details. Oh. Meron nga akong isang hindi makakalimutan sa US though, when I visited my son nung nag-aaral siya doon. Parang we went to this restaurant. We were having light snack before dinner because we wanted to go to a restaurant na nag-book ako. Okay. It's just that naglalakad kami. So I go, stop muna tayo dito. Yeah. Let's have a drink. Po kami. Tapos kukentuhan kami. And mahilig ako sa martini eh. So I was having martini. Tapos, biglang may lumapit na isang server. Sabi niya, I'd like to change your glass because it's not that chilled anymore. So, maglabas siya. Kasi di ba may martini, kailangan maganda, masarap, mag-chilled yung glass. So, pinalitan niya. Tapos, sarang, that is service. That's something that I would remember. And until now, I'd never forget about it. And I shared it with our bar team and to everyone na, that's how you deliver a notable, unforgettable experience. So surprise mo talaga. Those little touches na hindi naman nila kailangan gawin. But they did it. And that made me feel special. And that made me feel going back to them or me inspired creating that experience for my customers.
Correct. Parang talagang yun yung research mo eh. Sarap na research mo. Talagang food trip around the world and then you bring back dito sa Pilipinas. Okay, of course, we've talked about your restaurateur journey. Any future plans or other concepts you want to explore?
Yes, madaming akong gustong gawin na concept. But right now, I just opened a dim sum. It's a premium handmade dim sums in Eastwood Mall. I'm very proud of that concept kasi I'm a fan of dim sum. Pero I always look for good quality dim sums na hindi machine made. So ito, di ba, sanay tayo na ground pork yung nilalagay. Ito yung team namin. They shave the pork thinly, then they make it into a dim sum. So that's the concept. Parang ngayon, yes, think of cuisine when you create a concept, but think of how you would deliver them. Think, di ba, solving a problem like me, I'm craving for something really good quality dim sum. So we've created something like that na hoping na may mga tao ding naghahanap ng ganito. So that's Mr. Monk.
Grabe, no, you said kanina off cam that many times you've thought about ano magnegosyo, pero the way you talk about plans, food, your face really lights up. Parang I don't think that's gonna happen.
Ano lang siguro, I have to assemble a great team. Well, I have them, but if you want kasi to expand and create more concepts, hindi siya magagawa ng isang ganun eh. You have to really develop. Bibabyhin mo talaga. And sometimes yun yung nakakapagod.
Yeah. But finally nga, when you do, for example, have a family that comes in and they're so happy and they thank you for the food, I guess that makes
tanggal
it
pago.
Worth it.
Sarap-sarap ng pakiramdam.
I just realized that you have seen so many different shifts in society throughout your restaurateur days. Kasi when you started, wala pang social media marketing. Usually mas small based ang restaurants, if not like a standalone giant chain. Di ba grabe how it has changed? Now, you have your own social media account and market from there, di ba? Have you enjoyed trying to adapt to all those different eras?
Before pandemic, I wasn't using my social media accounts for business. Dumping of pictures, pag nag-travel, lalagay dyan paminsan-minsan. Pero dun ko lang talaga na-realize nung pandemic that it could be a big help for businesses. That's when I only took advantage of it. I had to learn it. Nung maraming na akong mga posts about food, aba, natawag akong KOL. May isang meeting, sabi sa akin. Parang binibrief ako dun sa project kasi daw KOL ako. So, habang tumatagal na yung meeting, nasa utak ko lang,
ang KOL!
So, nangyayak akong tanongin hanggang finally, hindi ko nakukuha yung sagot sa brief kasi sometimes may lumalabas. Yun pala yun, hala. So, parang, ayoko nung matapos. So, sabi ko, ano po yung KOL? Oh, ikaw yun! Yes. Ako ba yun? So, yun pala.
So, key opinion leader, yes. Ang KOL. It's, mga I guess, a new term. Yes.
Natawag na akong influencer. So, tuwang-tuwa ako na parang nag-expand na hindi ko inaasahan na magiging ganun ako. Even, you know, a regular person, they could take advantage.
Yeah, super double-edged sword though. Kasi,
oh, well, yes.
I mean, people can super rave about a dish and then suddenly, ang dami na nakapila to want to try that dish. But also, lalo na now, isang complaint lang, ipopost agad. Hirap
yes,
how
yes,
do you
yes,
deal
yes.
with that as a business, as a multiple business owner?
Laging ano yan, stepping back. Mm. If you're doing something good, great, just continue doing that. Yung concerns at saka yung feedback, that's actually very, very helpful for us. But sometimes, medyo kailangan na ring i-filter what could help us and what is distraction.
Yes.
So, yun, dapat ma-shift ng team kung ano yung dapat pakinggan at ano naman yung parang personal preference.
Di ba?
Minsan, pag mag-react ka at mag-adjust ka ng negosyo mo because of the personal preference dahil hindi ka sigurado dun sa ginagawa nyo as a team, then that could be dangerous and that could hurt the business.
Yeah. Grabe, no? Kaya talagang yan yung use social media wisely and think before you click. Libre, maging kind, di ba? I saw this online sometime back, maybe nga height of the pandemic, yung naging trending kawali ni Marvin.
Trending kawali?
Yes, diba trending kawali? I saw on just one e-commerce platform kanina, parang over 7,400 units sold of a trending kawali.
That's
ni
a
Marvin.
Scam!
Grabe, no? That's so crazy because it's your face.
They're using my name, my face, my voice na in AI.
Wait, you don't plan to sue?
We've been actually tracking them. We've been tracking them. And we've been reporting it to Meta. Ang dami na naming napababa na
pages.
Accounts.
Yeah.
So I guess, pag nakita ko nga, hindi lang ako, dami kaming mga artista na ginagawa ng fake accounts at ini-AI yung bosses. Pag may bagyo,
so
sasabihin pa nila na nabaha yung warehouse ko, that's why it's on sale. Minsan
so
kaboses ko na yung AI.
That is so insane.
So, yan, I guess ito yung generation at panahon na kailangan tayo maging discerning.
Super.
Nakakatakot ang technology.
Yeah.
It could help us a lot, but it could destroy us also.
And
we report every day, several accounts.
Oh my God.
So parang naging trabaho na nga namin mag-report.
Yeah.
So yeah, thank you for bringing that up. I hope people are watching and that is actually not ours.
No.
Anything that's not sold under our website
and
it's not seen on my accounts, verified accounts, that's not ours. I wanted to parang showcase a dish for you.
Yes.
Gagawin kita ng kochi tacos.
We are here where the magic happens. This is my first time in like a professional
kitchen. Ba?
Yes, as in. Pero syempre, ang specialty dito
Cochinilio.
Is the name of the restaurant.
Yeah, Cochi.
Cochinilio.
We made the nickname for Cochinilio.
Pero yun talaga yung plan mo from the very start? Or was it because the Cochi did so well nung pandemic that you decided to make it a restaurant?
Yes, exactly. Kasi parang a lot of people wanted to experience Cochinilio from the oven.
Yeah.
And in the restaurant, kasi nga, I was just doing that at home.
Yeah.
Request nila, lagyan ko daw ng restaurant. Matuto naman ako.
Kaya
masakit sa ulo ang restaurant.
Oh.
So, but what I'm about to show you is the most premium size Cochinilio. This is our 2.5
kg.
Yan.
Andiyan talaga siya.
Yeah.
Sobrang heavy duty ng oven. Amazing.
Yeah.
Parang naluluto na ako dito. Level pag
so this is our 2.5 kg.
Wow.
Mostly Chinese restaurants actually use this. This is the first time that a 2.5 kg is parang done in a cochinillo way.
Mm.
So this is so crispy.
Naamoy ko nga eh.
Yeah, but since I wanted to parang showcase a dish for you, gagawin kita ng kochi tacos. So, yan. First, our tortilla.
Oh, ito toast it.
Yeah. Ilang minutes to, Aldi? 2 minutes. Then,
yeah. Oh, while we're waiting for the 2 minutes, we have questions from your fans online. Ito agad-agad ang tanong ni Bong Fiel. Tips on how to cook lechon, please.
Hindi ako ganun kagaling magluto ng lechon. Actually, experience ko ng pagluluto ng lechon ay yung mga shinoot namin sa Jensen at sa mga iba't ibang lugar. But I've only done is yung cochinillo, yes, which is different, right, from lechon-lechon natin na malakihan, yes, na nagcha-charcoal grill. Yung cochinillo talaga sa Spain, niluluto siya sa brick oven. Pero tayo medyo mas industrial. We're cooking it in a deck oven.
Ito,
yeah,
deck
this
oven.
Is a deck oven.
Okay, okay. Pero yung kochi, nung na-discover mo yung parang final recipe mo na happy ka na, ano yung proseso na yun?
During pandemic, I was only baking breads, yes, pastries, cakes. Yun yung una kong pinag-aralan nung pandemic. Tapos may mga nag-order. Eh, ang lit-lit ng oven ko sa bahay. Eh, parang nagte 24/7, 7 days a week na ako nagbe-bake. So pagod na pagod sa pandemic, I know the owner of the oven, so yes, I ordered one from them. Amortized into many,
okay,
months.
Okay.
Kasi natatakot akong bumili during pandemic.
Uh-oh.
Ilagay ko sa garahe namin. Paglagay ko sa garahe namin, so from almost every day of baking breads and,
right,
cakes, naging 3 to 4 times a week na lang.
Uh-oh.
So meron akong 2 to 3 days na walang ginagawa
yung
oven. Uh-oh. Eh, paano bayaran ko yun? So I go, anong pwedeng gawin? I'm craving for parang crispy pork. And
yes,
na-experience ko yung cochinillo sa Spain. Sobrang sarap. Pagtawag ko sa supplier, may suckling pig sila.
Okay.
Tinuruan nila akong mag-butterfly.
Okay.
Tapos I like...
Sorry, butterfly.
Butterfly, to...
Okay.
Ang cute mo naman, butterfly.
Okay.
Tapos I like making dry rub. So
yes,
I made the rub for suckling pig, and then I roasted it. Aba, may magic. So masarap
siya. So technically, happy accident.
Happy craving accident.
Yeah.
Tapos buti na lang video ko yun. Pina-video ko sa staff ko. Kaya rin ako parang napapost ng madami lagi nun, na dati naman di ako nagpo-post. So when I posted it, a lot of people were actually interested also. Kasi nga nagbebenta na ako ng breads and cakes.
Yes.
Tapos sabi ko, tatry ko muna sa kaibigan ko para kung hindi talaga masarap, baka binobola ako ng sarili ko. So when my three friends said, masarap, Marvin. So dahan-dahan na nagtanggap na ako ng orders from other people. So ready na ang ating... Sobrang init nito, Bianca. Actually, ang dami ko ng mga sugat. Kaya nga tinakpan ko na yung iba kong sugat.
Oh my! I can imagine kapag nagluluto talaga natapang sikat.
Yeah. So, this is our kochi sisig. Pickled onions. Kamyas marmalade. So, the three sauces of kochi, when you order yung roast suckling pig,
either
by parts or the whole thing, Tum, I learned from a Lebanese friend, yung garlic sauce na sobrang healthy. Kala mo mayonnaise, but no, it's not. It's all garlic. Tapos, kamyas marmalade and green bell pepper sauce. Yung kamyas, makinuha ko sa neighbors namin and then I turned them into a sauce. Kasi parang kailangan ng something sweet with cochinillo and then garlicky and then medyo heat ng konti from the bell pepper sauce.
Okay.
Yeah.
Marvin is now assembling the tacos. Pero kung tutusin, ito na siya. Pero kasi ito, pre-timpla na.
Yes.
Tapos, so this is assembly.
We serve this also here.
Sisig.
As our kochi sisig. Since we created a lot of cocktails here and we serve good wines, we needed something for, you know, for munching.
Yes.
So, ito yung mga naiiwan sa mga late night menu namin for late nights of kochi.
Nakakatakam siya. Ooh. At saka ang generous nung dami nung ano, no?
Nung kochi.
Meron tayong nagtatanong na isang fan mo din. Kasi nga kochi is the, kumbaga, specialty. Tanong ni Regina Oreta, ano yung difference ng cochinillo mo sa iba?
I've tried other cochinillos also. They're also all very good. Sa akin kasi based sa experience ko sa Spain, of that delicious experience, but at the same time, I'm a fan of cebulechon.
Okay.
So yung lasa ng cochinillo ko, very flavorful, tasty. Mm-hmm. Kasi di ba, pag nasa Western countries tayo, yung palate nila, mas...
Kalma.
For Filipino, sasabihin natin, ayan, tabang.
Correct.
Pero ina-appreciate mo yung meat, ina-appreciate mo yung maraming bagay, more than just all the flavors that we put in as Filipinos. But ako talaga, gusto ko yung cebulechon.
Right.
So malasa yung cochinillo ko.
Yes. Okay, this is what onion is?
It's onion leeks.
Ah, and then after is the?
This is onions, pickled onions.
Pickled onions. Ah, kaya konti lang. Kasi yun yung dagdag asin.
And yung flavor ng onion na medyo sweet. Ayan. Just like that.
Kamyas.
Layers of flavors.
Napapatapa.
And crunch.
Ah, syempre yung crunchy, hindi mawawala. Ang galing no, pag may kinikrave ka lang, pag marunong, pag magaling ka magluto talaga, pag may kinikrave ka, gagawin mo lang.
Minsan kasi, di ba, ito nakikita nyo, ang sarap-sarap pag parang art na siya, yes. Nagpe-prepare ka. Pero, pag ipe-prep mo siya lahat,
correct.
Yun super ang pinaka-matrabaho yes. At pinaka-ayaw ng lahat. But, that's part of yes. cooking.
That sauce is?
This is toum.
T-O-U-M. Yes, T-O-U-M. Yeah. So that is not mayonnaise.
No, this is not kasi mayonnaise. This is just like garlic and olive oil.
Ang galing.
Let's try it.
Yes! O diba, prepared lovingly by
cheers.
Marvin. Cheers! Mm. Ang sarap! No bola, it's really good. Like the flavor of the different things that you put all together. So pag ganito, recipe na to, ikaw din nag...
Yung sisig, yeah, mm-hmm. of course, it's coming from our cochinillo. Tapos may inaanak, which is, he heads now the kitchen with mm-hmm. Aldi, our head chef. We're creating new items in the menu now because yeah. we're relaunching the menu this November.
Oh,
parang
okay.
yung one-year anniversary ni Kochi will be, you know, a new menu of where Kochi now, you know, from my garage. Yeah. So we're relaunching it this no. November.
From the garage to this. Oh, habang ina-enjoy ko pa kainyan ang Kochi tacos, may nagtatanong pa. Si Marian Isog, any other business in mind na gusto mong pasukin aside from food or restaurant?
Parang sa restaurant muna yata ako.
Thank ngayon. You.
Dahil mula teenager pa lang ako, mula bata ako, parang I dreamt of this life already. I know it is hard, but it's a dream that
yes.
I am actually living.
I know.
So kahit mahirap, laban lang.
Diba? Laban lang.
I dreamt of it eh.
At saka ang mga Pinoy, talagang pampahappy ang food.
Actually, kaya, malungkot ka, kakain ka.
Yes.
Masaya ka, kakain ka. So,
speaking of, yan din is mga tanong namin. Okay, anong hiling mo lutuin kapag bad trip ka?
Bad trip? Pag bad trip ako, syempre dapat ano, todo sinful food na.
Ito trip diba? Mo sa hiling mo. So that for you, that is?
I would cook bulalo. Talaga kukuha ako niya ng ano, yung bagong buto, yung malaki. Tapos papakulungan ko ng matagal. Tapos sa inyong gaganunin ko, kukunin ko yung maro. Tapos, syempre, pagkatapos, antok-antok ka.
Yes, so, hiyak matulog.
Pero, naman, I just wanted to treat myself.
Yes. Eto naman, pag good mood ka, what do you like?
Pag good mood, something good for my body. I like making sandwiches.
Okay.
So, I get a good bread, get a good piece of meat. Tas maraming lettuce, parang
yeah.
parang salad sandwich siya. That's actually my, sometimes my go-to at home.
Right.
Sa bahay, I control my food. Wala akong junk food as much as possible.
Ooh.
Kasi paglabas ko, hindi ko na makontrol. Dahil kailangan ko magtrabaho.
Yes,
kailangan
chika-chika ko sa mga tao.
Yeah, masarap na pagkain. We like, we need to make our food, you know, good.
Yes.
So, medyo, yun, when I'm home, controlled yung kinakain ko. Para naman, mabuhay ako ng mahaba.
Tama, healthy. Last, pag bored ka, super wala kang magawa. Nangyayari pa ba yun sa'yo?
Actually, kagabi, I was supposed to go somewhere, pero hindi natuloy. Eh, parang meron ako mga pagkain sa freezer ang tagal-tagal na. Wala akong magawa. So, kung ang gagawin ko? Eh, dinner time din. Hindi natuloy yung dinner ko. So, niluto ko lahat ng mga nasa freezer na seafood, plus sausages. So, parang gumawa ko ng pasta. Meron ko lang naman mag-isa, pero dami-dami kong niluto. Pero kasi masira.
Ang saya. We have a next question from Susan Interino. Are you still interested in showbiz? Kasi parang more on business na ang focus mo.
I am very, very interested. In fact, before pandemic, I would do one project a year.
Mm-hmm.
Kasi nga nami-miss ko siya.
Yes.
So, nag-pandemic lang. It was quite challenging to do, you know, bubble shoots.
Yes.
So ngayon, normal na ulit.
Mm-hmm.
I think I would resume to one project a year. Kasi nga nami-miss ko na. So,
yes.
Ayun, one project a year.
Oh, and the super exciting reunion project. That's what we're going to talk about with Marvin.
This would be our Valentine's offering. Oh. Kami ni Love Team, ni Jadina. Comeback movie na.
Aside from food, ang isa pang syempre, sobrang love na love mo in a, and is in your heart is your craft, acting.
Yes.
And I, for one, was so excited when Direk Antoinette Hadaunen started to tease little photos on her pages of a picture of her team, Direk Dan, I believe, yeah. And then you and
Project
Jolina
8, Montano. Yes. Finally, after many, many years of brainstorming and meeting and reading several scripts and materials, finally we've I think we've landed with a great material now that we're about to shoot very soon. And kung walang maging aberya, this would be our Valentine's offering. Kami ni Lab Team ni Jolina, comeback movie na. Ang tagal namin hindi gumawa ng pelikula. Parang nostalgia tong sasakyan sa amin. So we want to offer something na familiar sila, and then at the same time, you know, hindi yung parang hindi na sila masusurprise. So first, yun yung gusto namin i-achieve, yung kung ano yung kinasayahan nila dun sa mga pelikulang ginawa namin, mararamdaman nila ulit. So that's kind of very challenging kasi familiar pero gagawin namin bago. So that's the challenge for all of us kung paano yun ipapalabas sa Valentine's.
Yeah, super exciting, of course, under Direk JP Haba, to be shot abroad and here in Manila
and Malta.
What a beautiful location. I saw pictures from teasers.
Pictures pa lang ang nakikita ko rin. Kaya excited coming my experience in person.
Fans though did get konting patikim when you did a tourism campaign abroad
with Jolina.
So technically, that's your first work together in a long time. Is that correct?
You're correct. You're right. When Singapore Tourism Board got me as an ambassador, tapos yung year two, we wanted to make it mas romantic. So, nung pumunta ako ng Singapore, I was with Jolina. Kasi nung time ng first year ko, it was all online. Mm-hmm. I was working with several chefs from Singapore doing virtual cooking demonstrations.
Oh my gosh, that's so...
It was all virtual.
I don't miss that time.
Nagpunta ako ng Singapore, parang close na kami. Sabi ko, this is our first time to see each other, right? Sabi niya, oh yeah, this is our first time. So parang magkakilala na kami. And then yun na nga, when I went to Singapore, when we could travel already. So Jolina was with me and we traveled to Singapore.
Parang feeling ko, even if matagal kayong hindi nagka-work sa eksena, is it the type of friendship talaga na you really pick up where you left off the last time you saw each other?
Yes. Marirealize namin to kasi parang ang daming nanonood sa amin lagi pag magkasama kami na parang nakikita namin kasi sasabihin ng staff namin ganyan, parang sarap niyo panoorin, parang kayong nasa pelikula pag nag-uusap kayo. Kasi ganun talaga kami magkwentuhan. Yeah. And at the same time, I guess there was just that excitement of not seeing each other for a long time. Mm. Yeah, we would message or call each other, pero sobrang sandali. But being with each other yet in person, ramdam mo yung years of us working together, of our friendship, of, you know, what we went through when we were younger. Mm-hmm. Lahat ng kalokohan. Pero, now that we're adults, parang na-appreciate namin yung mga pinagdaanan namin. Yeah. And we chose to stay friends. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And we chose to, you know, communicate and be there for each other.
Shucks.
Nagtatawagan kami talaga.
Nauna lang siya ng konti sa'yo kasi siya nagbalik serye na siya. But are you open to do it? Kasi grabe din schedule ng series.
I know. Dati nga, before pandemic, I would do one project a year. Either a movie or a TV series. Pag na-plano ahead of time, I actually really want to because parang hindi ako nagtatrabaho pag nasa acting ako pag nasa entertainment work ako. Yeah. Sa showbiz, dadalang ka ng pagkain, may magbabasa na kayo ng script. So parang, ang sarap-sarap na trabaho. But then, it was hard. It was difficult.
Yes.
But now, I guess, realizing, doing the other side of me, doon ko na-realize, sarap pala maging artista.
Yeah.
Mahirap din because you have to, you know, internalize that character. Mm-hmm. Pero ang creative lang.
Yes.
Wala akong ibang iniisip na problema, but just my character.
Right. Are there any new gen actors or new gen filmmakers that you are interested to work with?
I've never really thought of it. Kasi akala ko, si Jolina lang ang artista. parang gusto ko lang gawin. Oh, parang yung comeback movie lang namin talaga yung pinatrabaho ko.
Pero you did have a reunion in the kitchen with Judy.
Oh,
that was
well,
so cute.
Yes. When Juday messaged all of us na it was her birthday episode pero parang reunion,
yes,
parang oh sino pumunta, yun ang ganda ng tanong sa kami
ni Batangas. Yes, Batangas,
yes, in their house. So doon nagkita kami ulit ni Jolina.
Yeah.
That was fun. The entire time parang kinikilabutan lang kami, magkakasama kami, nagkukulitan kami.
Yeah.
Actually, we could all do a project together. Of course, for us, mm-hmm, kasi parang ang sarap ulit magtrabaho.
Yes.
But also, I guess, for the audience na kinalakihan yung grupo na yun, yung
super
gimmick. So, I hope sana may isang project na magandang material that could land na parang pwede namin gawin lahat.
And if ever, yan ang tunay na batang 90s unite. If ever, acting, running your businesses in the next 5 years, where do you see yourself? Any bucket list item before you turn
50 nga, no, in 5 years? I hope I am still as creative as I think I am now, because
mm-hmm,
that's kind of what energizes me,
yeah,
in the morning. That makes my day, working with my team. Now that I'm about to do, you know, entertainment projects again, I hope I could go back and forth,
yes,
because these are the two industries that I love.
Yes.
Sana, yeah, this energy would somehow extend to
mm-hmm
a very long time. I like the service industry.
Mm-hmm.
I like the service in the restaurant. I like the service of inspiring people,
right,
through the characters that I do. So, I enjoy this life.
Yeah. Kaya more healthy years to
come.
Oh,
yes. That's why, you know, we take care of ourselves.
Yeah.
We try to live as balanced as possible,
mm-hmm,
our lifestyle.
Yeah.
We won't just have a long life, but we'll have a long and quality life. So,
yes,
yun.
Amen to that. What's your advice to all the starting entrepreneurs, whether Gen Z or older, who want to start their own business?
That's a great choice. Being an entrepreneur is something na it's not just for yourself, but yun nga yung sabi nila, entrepreneurs create jobs.
Mm-hmm.
So you actually help the country, you help the economy, you help a lot of people. But you really have to be ready, grinding every day. Because it might look glamorous when it's like this, being interviewed. Ganda yung lights.
Or nasa magazine,
nakapictorial. Diba? That's just one part of it. Most parts, ano siya, sleepless nights, solving problems, trying to be proactive. It's a fulfilling life, but it could be a lonely life because it's actually sometimes just you.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes, you know, when you don't have active partners helping you, it's just you thinking and solving
mm-hmm
things. But it's fulfilling because you're learning. Yung negosyo, it's a reflection of the character and personality
mm-hmm
of the entrepreneur. They just have to be ready, not just in the business,
mm-hmm,
but themselves as who they are.
Yeah. Shepherd, people have known you for many decades now, following you since your teens, 20s, and then until now. What is the B-side of Marvin Agustin? Parang hindi pa alam ng masyadong madaming tao.
Well, supposedly, parang B-side ko ito. Kung nag-a-acting ako, B-side ko is the restaurant. But I'm a frustrated athlete.
Really?
Yeah, I'm a frustrated athlete. So that's why meron ako laging sport
mm-hmm
na I anchor my lifestyle to.
Ah, which right now is golf.
Yes. Diyan ko dinidesign din yung buhay ko. Dahil connected yung either pag-artista, pag-negosyo doon sa personality ko.
Right.
So I try to be as balanced as possible. So I find the sport that could balance me more
mm-hmm
and could give me, you know, a better perspective. So hindi siya parang nag-sport ako para mawala yung utak ko sa negosyo,
mm,
no? Parang I'm honing and I'm training and I'm developing myself more. Kasi, like for example, golf is mas age appropriate. May physicality,
right,
pero mas mental.
Yes, correct.
And that's what I kind of need in the stage of the business that
mm
I have right now. More on strategies, more on planning. And that's where actually how golf helps me.
Mm-hmm.
Dun ko na-channel ang frustration ko sa sport. Mas nasa tamang stage na ako na nag-aaral ng golf.
Yeah, you're so active
yeah
and you're so fit. Well, thank you so much for hosting us here. Please invite everyone to visit your different restaurants. Go ahead.
Yes. So this is Kochi in BGC. Verve 2 Residences. Sana po bumisita kayo dito. We actually have a lot of foreigners and balikbayans na sobra kaming masaya when actually you guys visit here. Sometimes from the airport, dito sila nagre-reunion. So we're actually very, very happy serving you at nag-e-enjoy kaming makasama niya yung pamilya niyo. And we have other concepts. Mr. Monk in Eastwood and in Shangri-La and soon to open in Makati and in Alabama. Mm-hmm. And then of course, yung secret kitchens namin sa mga different malls. So thank you very much for supporting.
Grabe. See, 2 new restaurants pa opening and others to come. Good luck sa lahat. That is it for our show. Join us again next time for more amazing discoveries about your favorite stars. I'm Bianca Gonzalez and we'll see you next time here on The B-Side.
Para akong nag-travel ng 20 plus years, masarap pag-usapan. Kasi masarap alalahanin yung mga pinagsimulan, pinagtrabahuhan, yung mga na-achieve at mga hindi na-achieve, naiisip mo na sana magawa mo pa yung mga gusto mong gawin. But just like every other journey, masarap siya. Mapapangiti ka pag binabalik-balikan. Noon sinabi ni Bianca na nagla-light up daw ako. So, when I talk about concepts and new concepts na gusto kong gawin. Pero at the same time, sinasabi kong pagod na ako. Para akong loko-loko. I guess I'm really in love with this industry na ganun talaga. In every relationship, you go through ups and downs. Mapapagod ka, pero pag konting pahinga lang, parang gustong-gusto mo na naman gawin ulit. So, yeah, yun. I guess, alam kong ito talaga yung gusto ko. Ito yung comforting for me kahit challenging. Alam mo yun? Parang kung gusto mo where you are at yung track na ginagawa mo. Kasi wala namang madali. Sa dami ko nang pinagdaanan sa buhay at dami ko nang pinasok. Sinasabi ko lagi, parang kala ko nung pagtatanda ka na mas dadali na yung buhay kasi parang mas alam mo na. No, it's actually sometimes it's more difficult kasi parang mas marami kang alam. So parang mas marami kang gustong ayusin, baguhin. So nagiging never-ending yung gusto mong gawin. But I guess that's what life is. Di ba? Parang ang mysterious pa rin niya.
I don't cook at all, pero enjoy ako, lalo na sa mga cooking show, yung pag-prepare ng mga food, ng mga dishes. And that's actually my first time in like a proper kitchen. Tapos si Marvin pa yung naghanda. So super, super special. Hindi man ako na-inspire na magluto myself. Na-inspire ako kumain. I've known Marvin for quite some time. And even before ko siya makilala, alam ng lahat yung journey nga niya from before he started in showbiz. So, isa talaga siya sa pinaka-hardest workers ever. Kasi imagine ang dami niyang negosyo and yet ginagrow pa rin niya lahat ng yon. Ako ay frustrated negosyante. So, whenever ko siya nakausap tungkol sa mga learnings niya ganyan, na-inspire talaga ako. At alam kong yung life niya, marami ding ma-inspire na iba.